thought he was above a brother. Sucker. Kiss the white man ass, you ain't nothing but a sucker. Sucker. Hate our race like a motherfucker. Buster. Talk like your face looking whiter than a motherfucker. Bitch. You supposed to be a brother, brother. Right. When the white man pass you stiffen up like a motherfucker. Scary. You ashamed to a real brother. Real. Malcolm X will kick you in the ass if he saw you walking, nigga.
I can't support a black man. Ugandan Knuckles is just some meme that some liberal called racist. It's quite literally a meme. It's another fact. They're not racist. They're just stereotypes.
According to Owen, it's stereotypical for black men to have Ebola. According to Owen, it's stereotypical for black men to go around clicking their tongues like they're in an African tribe. According to Owen, it's stereotypical for black-owned countries to not have any source of clean water.
Just the way he acts, I've heard this guy Marcus say such fucked up things about white people in calls, especially if like a white person is being racist to him.
I didn't know that Owen's fans are so fucking retarded. They got a stick shoved so far up their fucking ass that they can't comprehend what this man just said. He literally said, I say fucked up shit to people when they're racist to me. I'm not even gonna say no more about that.
It makes no fucking sense at all. This guy can't literally be trying to call me a racist and calling Gitrog a Nazi.
Honestly, first of all, take your time to inspect Gitrog's profile, look at his past usernames, look at his inventory, look at the clothing that he wears on his Roblox avatar. Racism written all over it. Owen, don't even try to say that you're not racist when this is the first thing you see when you walk in your server.
In realistic roleplay, if you go to Chinatown at the mart, there's literally a character named Mr. Wong who's got a straw hat, yellow skin, and squinted eyes. You know, stereotypical Asian man. Typical Asian man. That means Marcus is a racist.
Hold on.
Hero children. Water, do you want to your clothes wash?
$5. I'm looking at the machine.
What are you doing? Do not touch my machine. Do not touch my machine.
Come on, I'm trying to buy cookie. I can't buy cookie without quarters.
Do not touch my machine.
I won't buy cookie.
I will grab the bell. I will grab my bell too.
This game out there, goddamn Albert Stuff played realistic roleplay. Albert Stuff literally played realistic roleplay. Do you think he would have found this game out on his own back in 2016 when it only had like 30 people playing? No, because the game wasn't doing jack back then. I can't even front though, Marcus has supported me a lot. If my channel would be nowhere today without Marcus's support and Marcus's game. And I have to thank Marcus a lot for that. Marcus was the homie. Marcus was one of the coolest guys I ever known for doing all the stuff he did for my channel. He gave me that first shout out and really put me out there. And then after that, my channel took off on its own. Marcus gave me spawners for videos. He gave me admin to help me with my videos. He's even been in some of my videos contributing and helping. I don't know what happened, but this guy definitely changed.
My channel's been kind of blowing up recently, and most of my viewers are now from the realistic roleplay community.
But one more thing, let's not forget the fact that this man Marcus760 had saved your career when that little Kumate versus Owen was going on, right?
Yeah, she thought he was a pedo, man. Until
pretty
Marcus
sure Marcus made 2 or 3 videos defending you, defending your career. But no, Owen jumps in. No, I made your game. I made it.
I'm a sellout coon. I made you.
You started playing RP2, okay? If you played RP1, you'd know it was more active than you made it, okay? He's not safe anymore at this point. It's fuck him and his dead grandmother, okay? That's how we are doing this.